The British Empire Medal. How good is that? The Queen knows my name. I keep telling people that. I hope she does.
Stephen Robinson, a jukebox maker, horse rider, entrepreneur, inventor, pilot, public speaker, and soon to be author. And he does all of this with just one arm. When Stephen was 18 years old, he lost his arm when involved in a serious motorcycle accident.
Well, it's a weird situation when somebody says to you, you've lost your right arm. First of all, I didn't believe them because I could still feel it. And there's this thing called phantom limb syndrome where people that have lost limbs still think they've got them or can still feel it. So I didn't believe them. But I asked the nurse one day to take me to a proper bathroom because there weren't bathrooms for patients on Ward 16 because everybody was bedbound. And she took me to the staff bathroom. And there was a mirror in that bathroom. And that's when I looked in the mirror for the first time and I saw that my right arm had gone. But also all my acne had gone. And I had really bad acne as a young teenage boy. And I'd really been bullied at school and in college because of my acne. So the fact that I'd been given all these antibiotics and medication, it cleared up my acne and I was absolutely overjoyed. And it didn't really matter that I'd lost an arm because my acne had gone. And I was so happy about that. So it was easy to deal with, really.
And Stephen's positive outlook on life has continued to inspire others by challenging himself to take on new hobbies, which is why he will be given the British Empire Medal for his services to disabled people.
I did all the things I'd failed at school, but I loved it, and I was hungry for education at a later age, really. So then I realised also that everything had become a problem for me, tying shoelaces, learning to cook food with one hand. So I liked problem solving. And that got me into restoring vintage jukeboxes, into vintage one-arm bandits. I know that's a bit of a pun, but it's true. And then I decided I wanted to take horse riding lessons, and I came fifth in the national dressage qualifiers. I was afraid of horses, that's why I did that one. And then I decided I wanted to learn to fly an aircraft because I was petrified of flying.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there where the air is red.
I really hope I have inspired people to realise that they can do much more than they think they can. I've spoken around the world, sharing my message that anything is possible, and it is truly possible. You know, so if anybody needs a motivational speaker, come and see me, I'll show you how you can achieve anything. Because some people will just talk a good talk and they'll say you can do this, you can do that, but there's no empirical evidence that they've done what they're even talking about. So I always feel that if I'm going to preach to people you can do anything and you can do the things that you're afraid of, then I need to put my money where my mouth is. And that's why I also took up flying and horse riding, because these were things that I was really afraid of.
And Stephen certainly won't be afraid when he visits Queen Elizabeth this summer after receiving his British Empire Medal.
This letter came through the post and it said Cabinet Office, and I thought, oh, what have I done wrong? I thought I'd done something wrong, and then he opened it and it said, you've been awarded the BEM. I had to Google BEM, I wasn't even certain what it was. And would you like to accept? And it had two tick boxes. One said, yes, I'd like to accept. I couldn't imagine anybody saying no, they wouldn't want to. Absolutely ecstatic. I'm flying high, excuse the aviation pun. Yeah, I'm doing loop-the-loops, and yeah, I'm super, super happy.